Good morning. Myself Vinod Taide, lecturer in electronics, Government Polytechnic Nashik, Maharashtra, India. Today we will see the program to perform division of two 8-bit numbers for microcontroller 8051. For that we have a program statement. Write assembly language program to perform division of two 8-bit numbers which are stored in 0200H and 0201H of external memory. We have to write this program using external memory. So external memory, here we have to change external memory and store result in 0200H quotient and 0203H remainder. So these are the conditions already given that our divisor is at 0200 and dividend is at 0201, and we have to store the result in the external memory, correct? So for this we have to use the instruction DIVAB. And what is the requirement of DIVAB? That your dividend should be in A register and your divisor should be in the B register. Then only you can perform the division. And by default, it will store your quotient into the A register and remainder in the B register. Again, see, we are using here external memory. So to access the external memory, we have to use the MOVX instruction also. So see how we can write the program. So to start with, initially, we will start with the ORG, origin instruction 0000H. So it will set the location of your program into the program memory. The first instruction you will write, we have to initialize a pointer here, a memory pointer. Now, as we are using the external memory, so we will require a memory pointer of 16 bit because the external memory is a 16 bit, correct? So we will use the instruction move DPTR comma hash 0200H. DPTR is a data pointer. We use this to access the external data memory, correct? So initially your DPTR is 0200H, so that it will point to the first memory location where you have your first data. Assume your data, suppose this is your dividend and this is your divisor, correct? So we have to perform 0B divided by 02. Okay, so we will have to write this like this, 02 here and 0B here. See why. So the next instruction is move X A comma at the rate DPTR. So what you will get in accumulator, you will get the value pointed by DPTR, that is 02H, correct? So what next we have to do? We have to take the second value in the B. But see, our 02 is what? It is a divisor. So divisor should be in the B register. So first I will move this B, A, value of A into the B. So your B will become 02H. And then we will increment the DPTR and we will again use a instruction move A at the rate DPTR. why this? Because here we are accessing the external memory, and the external memory we can access only using the accumulator register. That's why we have to do this arrangement, that first take the value in A, shift that value into the B, then again increment pointer and take the second value into the A. Correct? Because move X B comma @DPTR, this type of instruction is not available in the microcontroller. So whatever the access we have to access using the accumulator only. So up to this point, we have A is equal to 0B and B is equal to 02. So both the values we already have in A and B. So now we can use our division instruction. So you will write DIV AB. It means it will perform operation A divided by B. It will perform the operation A divided by B. And it will give you result in A. It will give you the quotient. And in B, it will give you a reminder of your result. Whatever the values are there, you will get. Correct? Also, it will set the overflow flag. Correct? It will depend on the value of B. So we have to observe that overflow also. Now the next task is, our division is complete. We have result in A and B. Now the next task is, we have to store our result in 0202 as well as in 0203H. So the value of A, the quotient, we have to store into the 0202H. For that, simply we will increment DPTR, because currently DPTR value is what? It is, in this case, it is DPTR is equal to 0201 here, correct? So DPTR is equal to 0203H here. 02H here, correct? So you will get DPTR is equal to 0202H. After this, you have to move the value of accumulator into the DPTR, correct? So move X @DPTR comma A. In this case, @DPTR is the destination and A is the source. So @DPTR means at 0202H, you will get the value of your quotient. After this, we have to store the value of B. So again, first you will have to increment the DPTR. So your DPTR, it will be 0203 now, correct? DPTR. And again, we will have to shift the content of B register to A register. Then only you can write this DPTR comma A, because again move X instruction work only with the accumulator. So B, the value of B, which is nothing but your remainder, you will take it into the accumulator only for storing purpose. And after that, the 0203, it will hold the value of your remainder. As your task is complete, simply you will write the end instruction. Correct? So this is what we have to write to perform the division of two numbers, 8-bit numbers, by using external memory. Once again, see ORG to start the program. Move DPTR comma #0200H to initialize the external memory pointer, because memory is 16-bit. Move XA @DPTR, take the value from the first memory location into the accumulator. As we are using external memory, we are writing here move X. So you will get the value A is equal to 02. Move this value into the B register. Again, increment DPTR. It will point to the next memory location. Take the second value into the A. Again, using the move X instruction. So A will be 0B. Now perform the division. It will perform A divide by B operation. It will store result in A and B. A quotient, B remainder. Then increment DPTR. It will be 0202. Store quotient first at 0202. Increment DPTR. Move the value of B to the A. And then store that value at 0203H. This is how simply you can write a program for the division. So after this, immediately we will run the same program onto the MIDE simulator tool. So for that, I will open this MIDE tool, MIDE 51. Here, first take the new file. So it will open this editor. In this editor, we have to write the same program of division. So as we already have the copy, so I will simply copy the same program and I will paste here. So it will speed up our programming. So after writing your program here, save as, give one name, div8.asm. Save. See, we have the same program here. Now, as per our procedure, first step we have to do, that is build the current file. When you will build, it will check for the syntax error. If there is no any error, it will display no errors. If there is no any error, simply go to the build and sim tab. When you will press this build and sim, it will open one emulator. In this emulator, again, you will find your five sub windows. In that, the disassemble code window is there. In that window, you will find your program. Now, in this case, as it is an external memory, what is the condition? The memory is 0200 and numbers we have 02 and 0B. So we'll go to the external RAM window. First, go to this mode, change this mode to 8051. And in this external RAM memory, first we have to find out the address 0200. So here we will have to scroll down to find this 0200 address of your external memory. See here, this is our 0200 address. On this address, first we have to store the value, that is 02. So double click here. It will open a small window. In that, you have to enter the new value, that is 02. Then the 0201, double click, enter your second value, 0B. Press OK. So it will store the values of divisor and dividend, correct? In 0200 and 0201. Remember, this time you have to store into the external RAM, not into the internal RAM, correct? And at the address 0200. So after storing this, what we have to do? Simply run the program step by step. So first instruction, move DPTR 200. So when I will run this, you will find the DPTR is equal to 0200H. After that, move XA at the rate DPTR, means in accumulator, you should get the first value. See, your accumulator is 02H now, the first value. After that, we have to move this first value to the B register. So again, press this. It will get copied into the B. Now your B is 02. After this, increment the DPTR. So DPTR will be 0201. Now again take the value pointed by DPTR into the A. So press this, you will get A is equal to 0B. Now perform the division and you will immediately get result in A and B itself in a single step. So press this, see in A you have 05 and remainder is 01. If we go for the decimal equivalent, so 0B is what? It is equivalent to 11. And we are performing 11 divided by 02. So if we perform 11 divided by 02, we get quotient is equal to 5 and remainder is equal to 01. This is a normal decimal arithmetic. So this is our result. The next task is we have to store the value of A and B in the same external memory. For that, first increment the DPTR. Now increment is DPTR, so it will become 0202 and store the value of A at 0200. So press this button once again. See here, it 0202, you will get the value of A, which is nothing but your quotient. After that, increment the DPTR. Now it will point to the 0203. Take the value of B into the A first. So A is 01 now. And again move the content of A at 0203. So C, 02, 0B, these are your input numbers. 05 and 01, these are your output numbers. So 0202, you have quotient. And at 0203, you have your remainder. So up to this point, our task is complete. If you wish to run the same program for different numbers, then simply reset this and see, as it is external memory, it will not get reset. So you will have to change these numbers here. Suppose this is 05 now and this number is A2, A3. I'm taking odd number. So again, step by step procedure, you can go here and it will update your result. See, A3 divided by 05, what is your result? 20 is the quotient and 3 is the remainder, correct? So this is a generic program. Remember, always you should have a practice to write program like this. Because in such program, you can change your operand without changing any instruction of your program. There are some simple ways also to write the programs. The same program you can write by using 4 instructions only. But in that case, if you have to change the data, you will have to change your program also. So you should write a program like this, which can perform division of any numbers. Correct? Okay. So up to this point, our task is complete. We have written a program of division and we have simulated the same program using the simulator. Thank you.